Welcome to my channel Kitchen Explorer. In today's video, we will see a new recipe of veg momos manchurian. It turns out very delicious and very simple to prepare. So let's get started. First, let's prepare a dough. So to a bowl, add 1 cup of maida, put some salt as per taste, and oil 1 teaspoon. Give everything a good mix. Let all the ingredients combine well. Now add water and make a dough out of it. Remember, we need to add water gradually and we need to make a medium soft dough. Knead the dough well. See the stiffness of the dough? This is perfect. Now let's keep it aside for 15 minutes. Now let's prepare stuffing. So to a pan, add 1 to 2 tablespoons of oil. Now to it, add chopped ginger 1 inch and 4 chopped cloves of garlic. Just saute until the raw smell goes. Now to it, let's add 1/4 cup of chopped onion. Just saute it for few seconds. When the onion turns into slight pink in color, now to it let's add 1 cup of grated cabbage, carrot 1/4 cup. Just saute it for few seconds, we don't want to lose the crunch of vegetables. Now to it let's add spring onion 1/4 cup. Just saute it. Now to it, add some salt as per taste. Now add soy sauce 1 teaspoon. Just saute it for a few seconds and here it's done with the preparation of stuffing. I forgot to add pepper powder while cooking, so now I'm adding 1/4 teaspoon of pepper powder. Just give it a mix. You can add while cooking itself. So here it's done with the stuffing and now let's see our dough. After 15 minutes, let's knead the dough once again. So now let's divide the dough into two portions. Just roll it. So now let's roll it using rolling pin. Now sprinkle some maida and we need to roll it. Roll it like a big roti. Yeah, this is perfect. And now let's cut it to a round shape. So here I've taken this bowl. You can take any lid and you can cut it so that you'll get an even shape. Make sure that you roll it thin or else you won't get a good taste while eating. So now I'll show how to do stuffing. So take a momo sheet, put little stuffing. Now seal the edges using water. And now let's do the process of folding. So we need to make a pleats and then fold it. Make a pleats and press it, that time you'll get a folding. Keeping a little distance in between, we need to make foldings. See the way I've showed in the video, even you need to do it in the same way. So here I've finished making pleats and now let's assemble it. Bring all the foldings together. Just press it. And we need to make a small hole on the top. In the same way I've prepared rest of the momos. Now let's go to the process of steaming. So here I've taken my steel plate. I've greased it with oil. Now I'm going to steam it in kadai. So this is my old kadai. So put little water, place a stand and close the lid and we need to steam it for 15 minutes in a medium flame. See here, after 15 minutes our momos are steamed, and let it cool down. To prepare a manchurian sauce, to a pan add 1 to 2 tablespoons of oil. Now to it add chopped ginger 2 inch and chopped garlic 4 cloves. Now to it let's add 1 chopped green chilli, 1 chopped small onion. Just saute it for few seconds until the raw smell disappears. And now to it let's add 1/4 cup of capsicum. Give a good mix. Now to it add some salt as per taste. Just saute it for few seconds. And now to it let's add 1 teaspoon of vinegar. Saute it. Now add black soya sauce 2 tablespoons. Just give a good mix. And now to it let's add green chili sauce 1 tablespoon. Just saute it. Now add tomato ketchup 2 tablespoons. Give a good mix. Now to it let's add little water. And now let's add corn flour slurry. So here I've taken 1 tablespoon of corn flour and 2 tablespoons of water. Just add little and give a good mix. Just cook it for 1 to 2 minutes. Now here I'm going to add spring onion 1/4 cup. Give a good mix and off to flame. Now place the steamed veg momos on it. Mix it, make sure that you coat each and every momo with the sauce. So here it's done with the recipe. If you like this recipe, do like, share and subscribe my channel. And if you're new to my channel and not yet subscribed, then do subscribe it and press on the bell icon button to get the notification of my new recipe. If you're having any comments or suggestions, leave it in the comment section below. Thank you.